This is Siddhant Kulkarni. We have started with the unit number 6 in the last two video lectures, where we have gone through two important points of this particular unit, including internal memory along with the functional units of C67X processor. Today we will continue our discussion related to the peripherals associated with C67X processor. So the question can be asked like, enlist the on-chip peripherals of TMS320 C67X processor and explain any two in detail. The question can be asked directly for 6 or 8 marks. So to list out some of the on-chip peripherals available with the C67X processor, to name the few, there are two 32-bit timers, two multi-channel buffered serial ports. Multi-channel buffered serial port help in serial communication. The serial communication we have already covered in the LPC2148. Some of the we can say that it is similar to in some respect with the serial port what we have studied in LPC2148. Then direct memory access, we have already talked about direct memory access in the last lecture, where it is used when we need to transfer chunk of the data from outside memory to the processor or from CPU to the outside memory. Then next is enhanced direct memory access. It is extended version of DMA, external memory interface EMIF. When a CPU need to access external memory, EMIF comes into the picture. Host port interface, once again the name itself indicates host port. So the CPU will act as a host, and it creates an interface between CPU and peripheral devices. Then boot configuration, booting sequence is always required for any of the controller if you are talking about. Interrupt selector, then expansion bus and power down logic. So the question can be asked, list out the on-chip peripherals. These are some of the on-chip peripherals and explain any two in detail. So we'll talk about two peripherals which are most important in this DSP processor, MCBSP. So we have already talked about MCBSP. It stands for multi-channel buffered serial ports. So it stands for multi-channel buffered serial ports, MCBSP. Now there are two MCBSP ports, namely MCBSP0 and MCBSP1. It provides full duplex communication. As you all know, what is a duplex communication? There are three types of communication: simplex, half duplex and full duplex. So semi selection size of 8, 12, 16, 20, 24 or 32 bits. As you all know, the data, when it is to be transferred in the serial fashion, we need to create a frame. The frame size can be of 8, 12, 16, 20, 24 or 32 bits. That's what the point indicates. Independent framing and clocking for receive and transmit. So framing comes into the picture when we are talking about serial communication, and to synchronize it we require clock pulses. So it has independent framing and clocking for receive and transmit, external shift clock or internal programmable clock for data transfer. So we can have an internal programmable clock or external shift clock when we need to transfer a data in the serial fashion from source to the destination. Next bit is 8-bit data transfer with an option of LSB or MSB first. You already know that data can be transferred in the as LSB first or MSB first. Usually LSBs are transferred first in serial type of communication. Double buffered resistor which allows continuous data transmission. Then auto buffering capability through 5-channel DMA controller. We already talked about DMA controller, and auto buffering capability helps in this DMA transfer of the data when a chunk of the data need to be transferred. Mu law and A law compounding. I hope these concepts are clear to in the communication subject. So this is not the place to talk about mu law and A law compounding. You already have basic knowledge of it. Direct interface to industry standard codes, A2D, D2A converter, etc. So these are some of the features of MCBSP peripheral of DSP processor. Next we will talk about timer and counter feature. It is already covered in the block diagram also. We are just revising these things. There are two 32-bit general purpose timers used for this function. The function of this timer is to give time pulses to for particular event. It can count the external events which are occurring, then it can use to generate pulses and interrupt the CPU. Send synchronization events to the DMA and EDMA controller. These are some of the features of timer and counter. And as you all know, timers and counter are used to generate delays also. Here also it can be used, but it is not intended to do in the DSP processor. Next point in the unit is the instruction set. So we will cover this instruction set point and then we will stop. So there are different type of instructions in the C67X processor, namely arithmetic operations, logical operations, comparison operation, shift operation, branch operation, move operation, and load and store operation. So we'll try to cover these instructions depending on the functional unit which we have studied. Let's say for .el unit, this is a ALU unit which is .el unit, and where we can have some of the instructions which can be executed wholly and solely in the .el unit. So let's say add and subtract are two instructions which can be covered as a part of .el unit. It stands for signed unsigned integer addition subtraction without saturation. So this is important when I am talking about add and subtract just without any subscript. So it stands for without saturation. Then logical AND and OR operation, bitwise AND and operation can also be executed in .el unit. Then CMPEQ, you already know that compare if equal. So this equality condition is checked. Compare operation for equality. Then compare if greater than, compare operation for greater than, something like that. So these comparison operations can also be taken care by .el unit. Branch display. So B, if you can see BDISP, DISP, just you can see this indicates the displacement, branch operation using a displacement. Then BREG, branch operation using register. So if we need to branch a control of the program from one particular memory location to another memory location, this branch command will be helpful. So BDISP, BREG are some of the instructions which can be used in .el unit. Let's talk about .es unit. It is another ALU unit where arithmetic operations like add to, this is important instruction, add to. This instruction may be asked in the examination if examiner just want to check whether you have neatly and correctly studied the instructions or not. So it stands for 2 TWO, 16 bit integer addition on upper and lower register halves. So it will add two 16 bit integers, and the addition result will be stored in upper and lower register halves. So add to stands for this particular thing. And an OR is having the same function as it was in the case of .el unit. Shift left, so it is arithmetic shift. You already know the difference between arithmetic shift and logical shift and how it results in. So we have studied this as a part of LPC 214. It also it stands true here also. Then SHRU, logical shift right operation. So this is for unsigned number. So shift left and shift right. So if you can observe the difference between .el and .es unit, here .el unit supports branch instruction and here .es unit supports shift instruction. Next is .em unit. As you all aware of, there are three ALUs if I'm talking about one register file. There are three ALUs if I'm talking about second register file. But there is only one multiplier unit each in these register files. So .em functional unit, MPYL. Now this last bit indicates something to you in every instruction related to the multiply. MPYL, it is signed unsigned integer multiply of LSB and LSB. If two LSBs need to be multiplied, we'll have this subscript L at the end. Then MPYH for MSB, where I need to multiply 16 MSB into 16 MSB operation. Now here HL, so I need to multiply MSB with LSB, then I will use this HL as the subscript. Then MPYLH, LSB into MSB. So these are four versions of multiply instruction. It is not the case that it cannot be asked, it may be asked in the examination. So you should be aware of, depending on this last letter of the instruction, you can understand what it actually multiplying, what it is actually multiplying. Next is .d unit. The .d unit, once again another ALU where some of the arithmetic instruction and load and store instruction. This is important. This is the what I can say, that this is the specific purpose of .d unit, where it is taking care of load and store instruction. arithmetic operations like addition and subtraction, as it was in the case of .l and .s unit. .d unit also taking care of addition and subtraction, but load and store are specific functions. Now what it loads? It load a byte from memory with 5/15-bit unsigned constant offset or register offset. We are going to see these instructions in detail, where we will understand the addressing modes, and in the addressing mode these instructions will be more and more clear. Then likewise, load here, it stores a byte to the memory. So load byte from memory, store byte to the memory. Loading or storing is always taken care, considering CPU as a reference. From the CPU, whether I am storing, or to the CPU I am loading. So depending on this, you can understand the basics of this particular thing. So this completes our instruction, overall instruction. Then the next bit that we will going to cover in the next video lecture is explain addressing modes for TMS320C67X processor with an example. So this is the most important bit of the topic, and you should not miss this. So in the next lecture, coming lecture, I will come up with this addressing modes for TMS67X processor. Till then, be safe, stay at home, and keep learning. Thank you very much.